Hello dear students, today we will solve some example on the division topic. Okay, so what is the meaning of division? Division means repeated subtraction. Division means repeated subtraction. Okay, so now we will solve some examples. So first we have seen division by repeated subtraction. Okay, so these examples we have to solve by using repeated subtraction method. Okay, so see here 36 divided by 6. Here 36 is the dividend, 6 is the divisor, and we have to find out the quotient, and quotient means the result of the division. Okay, so this example we have to solve by using repeated subtraction. So first write the dividend, and every time 6 subtract. Okay, and when 0 comes, then stop and then count how many times you subtracted. That will be the quotient of your example. Okay, so 36 minus 6, 6 minus 6, 0, 3, there is no any digit, means 30. 36 minus 6, 30, then again subtract 6 by using backward counting, you will get the answer directly. Okay, now 30 minus 6, 24, 24 minus 6, 18, 18 minus 6, 12, 12 minus 6, 6, and 6 minus 6, 0. When 0 comes, then stop your process and then count how many times you subtracted 6. Okay, so see here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 times you subtracted 6. So you get 0 as the remainder. Okay, so 6 is our answer or the quotient. Okay, so 6 are 36. You can cross check your answer. 6 are 36 means our answer is correct. Then next example, 24 divided by 4, and we have to find out the quotient. Okay, so write 24 and every time subtract 4. 4 minus 4, 0. 2, there is no any digit, means consider 0 is there. 2 minus 0, 2. Then again subtract 4. 20 minus 4, 16. 16 minus 4, 12. 12 minus 4, 8. 8 minus 4, 4. And 4 minus 4, 0. Okay, then when 0 comes, then stop your process of subtracting and then count how many times you subtracted 4. So 1 time, 2 time, 3 time, 4 time, 5 time, and 6 times. Okay, so write 6 is our quotient. Okay, you can cross check your answer. 4, 6 are 24. Okay, so our answer is correct. Next example, divide by using number line. You can do any operation on the number line. What is the number line? Number line is the line having numbers. Okay, so you can do any operation, means addition, subtraction, multiplication, or division on this number line. Okay, so see, 12 divided by 2, and here we have to find out the quotient. So 12, where is 12 on number line? Here 12. Okay, and 2 is the divisor, means every time you have to subtract 2 from the 12. Okay, so 12 minus 2, go 2 step backward. 12 minus 2, 10. And 10 minus 2, 8. 8 minus 2, 6. 6 minus 2, 4. 4 minus 2, 2. And 2 minus 2, 0. Here also when 0 comes, then stop and then count how many times you comes backward. Okay, see here 1 time, 2 time, 3 times, 4 times, 5 times, and 6 times. Okay, so 6 is the answer. You can cross check your answer. 2 6 are 12, means our answer is correct. Then next, 14 divided by 7. Okay, so where is 14 on number line? 14, and every time we have to come 7 step backward. Okay, so see here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, so 14 to 7. Then again come 7 step backward. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, then come 1 and 2. So 2 is our answer. Okay, you can cross check your answer. 7, 2 are 14. Okay, next, divide using multiplication tables. Or another name for this method is division by long division method. Okay, See the example, 12 divided by 2. Okay, so see first digit, it is smaller than 2. So what you will do, write 0 here and subtract 0 from 1. 1 minus 0, 1. Then take this 2 down. Now you have to cross check whether this way is divisible by 2. Means you have to reset the table of 2 and you have to see whether this way comes in the table of 2 or not. Okay, so 12 comes in the table of 2. 2 6 are 12. So write here 6. 2 6 are 12. Okay. Then subtract 12 from 12. 2 minus 2 0. 1 minus 1 0. So quotient. This is the quotient. Means 6 is the quotient and remainder is 0. Next example, 27 divided by 3. Okay. So see, first digit is 2. It is smaller than 3, means 2 is not divisible by 3 because 2 is smaller than 3. So write here 0. Okay. And subtract 0 from 2. 2 minus 0, 2. Then take this 7 down. Now check whether this 27 come in the table of 3 or not. Okay. So in the table of 3, 27 comes. 3 9s are 27. So write here 9. Subtract 27 from 27. 7 minus 7 0. 2 minus 2 0. Okay, so quotient is 0. 9 means 9 and remainder is 0. Then next example, 125 divided by 5. Okay, so see here, first digit is 1. It is smaller than 5. So what you will do, write here 0 and subtract 0 from 1. Okay, so 1 minus 0, 1. Then take next digit down. Which number is formed here? 12. Okay, so this 12 is not divisible by 5 because it does not come in the table of 5. 5 1s are 5, 5 2s are 10, 5 3s are 15. Means 12 does not come in the table of 5. So what you will do then? Check out which is the smaller number than 12 that comes in the table of 5. Okay, so see here, 5 1s are 5, 5 2s are 10, 10 comes in the table of 5. So write that number 5, 2s are 10. Okay, then subtract 10 from 12. 2 minus 0, 2. 1 minus 1, 0. Now next step, take next digit down. 25 number is formed and it is divisible by 5. 5 5s are 25. So write here 5 and 25 subtract from 25. 5 minus 5 0. 2 minus 2 0. Okay. So our answer is ready. 25. 0 25 means 25. 25 is the quotient and remainder is 0. Okay. Here last 0 remains. Okay. Means that is the remainder. Then next example, 120 divided by 2. Okay, so see here, first digit is 1. It is not divisible by 2. Okay, so write here 0 and subtract 0 from 1. 1 minus 0, 1. Then take this 2 down here. Now check whether 12 comes in the table of 2 or not. So in the table of 2, 12 comes. 2 6 are 12. So 6 right here and 12 subtract from 12. 12 minus 12, 0. Then next step, here 0 remains. So take it down. Okay. So now 0 divided by 2. You know the property of the division. 0 divided by any number. So you will get 0 quotient. So right here 0 and subtract 0 from 0. 0 minus 0. Next example, divide by using multiplication tables. Okay. See here, 72 divided by 2. So first digit is 7. Now check whether this 7 comes in the table of 2 or not. Okay, so 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 4, 2 3s are 6, 2 4s are 8. Means in the table of 2, 7 does not come. So what to do? Then search the number that is smaller than 7 and comes in the table of 2, okay. So that number is 2, 3 are 6, 2, 3 are 6. So write here 3 and subtract 6 from 7, okay. 7 minus 6, 1, then take this next digit down, okay. So 12. Now divide this 12 by 2, means check at which position comes 12 in the table of 2, okay. So 2, 6 are 12, 2, 6 are 12, so write here 6 and subtract 12 from 12, 2 minus 2, 0, 1 minus 1, 0, so 36 is the quotient, means answer of division, and 0 is the remainder. Next example, 63 divided by 3, okay. So first digit is 6. Now check whether this 6 comes in the table of 3 or not. 3 ones are 3, 3 twos are 6, okay. So 6 comes in the table of 3 at second position, okay. So 3 twos are 6, means subtract 6 from 6, 6 minus 6, 0, then take 3 down, okay. Now divide this 3 by 3, okay. So 3 ones are 3 in the table of 3, 3 comes at the first position, so write here 1 and subtract 3, 3 from 3, 3 minus 3, 0, okay. So 21 is the quotient and 0 is the remainder. Next example, 42 divided by 4, okay. So see, first digit is 4, it is divisible by 4, means 4 ones are 4 in the table of 4, 4 comes at first position, okay. 4 ones are 4, then subtract that 4 from 4, 4 minus 4, 0, then take 2 down, okay. After taking the next digit down, the number is formed that is smaller than divisor, okay. So here 2 number is formed, 0 2 means 2 number is formed, and that is smaller than divisor, okay. So in this condition you have to write here 0 and subtract 0 from 2, okay. 2 minus 0, 2, okay. Now further you can't divide this number, okay, because 2 is smaller than 4, so keep as it, okay. Our answer is ready. This 10 is the quotient and 2 is the remainder, okay. 2 is the remainder. Quotient is 10 and the remainder is 2, okay. Next example, 80 divided by 4. First digit is 8, 4, 2's are 8, okay. So 8 minus 8, 0, then take next digit down, 0 is here, okay. So 0 divided by any number, quotient will 0, means 0 right here, and subtract 0 from 0, 0 minus 0, 0, okay. So here 20 is the quotient and 0 is the remainder, okay. Next example, word problems are there, okay. If 5 boys sit on one bench, 5 boys can sit, how many benches are required for 85 boys to sit, okay. So see here, write the information that is given. Number of boys can sit on one bench, number of boys can sit on one bench is equal to 5, okay. Then this thing that we have to find out, that is number of benches required, numbers of benches required to sit 85 boys is equal to 85 divided by 5. Okay, so solve this. 85 divided by 5. The first digit is 8. Okay, this 8 does not come in the table of 5. So what to do? Solve the smaller number than 8, that is divisible by 5, that is 5 only. 5 ones are 5. So right, 5 ones are 5. Subtract 5 from 8. 8 minus 5 is 3. Then take next digit down here. 35 number is formed and it is divisible by 5. 5 sevens are 35. 5 sevens are 35. Then subtract 35 from 35. So you will get 0 as the remainder. Okay, so how many benches are required? 17 benches are required. Quotient is 17. So 17 benches are required to seat 85 boys. Next example, Shubham paid rupees 20 for 2 pens. How much did he pay for 1 pen? Okay, so see the solution. Solution, cost of 2 pens is equal to rupees 20. Hence the cost of 1 pen is equal to 20 divided by 2. Okay, so do this operation, 20 divided by 2. So first digit is 2. So 2 ones are 2. 2 minus 2 0. Next digit down 0. 0 divided by 2 0 means 0 1 0 0. So answer is 10. So cost of 1 pen is 10 rupees. Okay.